On October 3rd, he asked me what day it was.
Hey, what day is it?
It's October 3rd.
Beğenmedin çok herhalde.
Aman akıllı iki şarkın tuttu triplere bak.
Evet hepsi bak. Benim. Hepsi benim. Isıtıcıyı da açtırdım şimdi kendime özel. Isınacağım burada.
Aynen bu kafe de senin zaten.
Kafe benim alacağım onun mekanı.
Yanında. Aynen canım. Üç şu kahveyi içmeden abi. Kendine gelemiyorsun değil mi sen?
Kendime gelemem.
Yok. Hala I ain't with that. Devil try to get his lick back. Pull up, spin.
I want to be by myself. This is what I'm craving, and I'm not lonely. Like, this is all my choice, you know what I'm saying? I'm choosing to be by myself. I'm choosing to do these things by myself.
It's day 10 of spring cleaning, and today we are cleaning the windows and baseboards. For the windowsills, I'm first dusting off the excess dirt, and then I'm going in with a soapy water mixture and a sponge to wipe it all down, followed by a little glass cleaning. I'm going in with that same mixture and a small cleaning brush for the baseboards. I continued this throughout the entire apartment. It literally took forever, but I am so glad it's done.
Person has leukemia and soiled the floors as a result. I'm glad we could help with the clean.
Amazon closet organization favorites. First are these acrylic shelf dividers that I use to keep my handbags in place, and it keeps them from falling over on top of each other. Next is this handbag display stand with adjustable height, this acrylic sunglasses organizer that fits 12 pairs of sunnies, a velvet lined 5-drawer jewelry organizer, and these stackable shoe organizers that give you 50% more storage space. And last are these S-hooks that you can use to organize your jeans. Comment shop below for links or link in bio to shop.
Cleaning random things that you wanted to see. Today was bins. So I chose to do the outside bin because it was bin day. You can do your inside bins as well. So I put some dishwashing liquid in there with some water, and then I've just given it a scrub down with an old broom, which now is my bin broom. So we rinse it off, wipe it out, tip it out. It's not immaculately clean, but it is a lot cleaner than it was.
Japanese storage solutions you didn't know you needed. These skinny cabinets are game-changing. It perfectly stores cleaning supplies, toilet paper, and takes up no space. I think this would be great in a narrow hallway. I'm using a bread box to tackle this corner of vitamins in the kitchen. Adding a dolly inside allows me to see everything. This would also be perfect for snacks. And here's another version in my bathroom. Concealed storage will make a space look so clean and give you peace of mind. Because everything has a spot now, it makes cleaning so fast. And these are all from Yamazaki Home, which I'll link in my storefront.
How many of you, like me, are tired of digging through a pile of pots and pans every time you need to cook a meal? Let's say goodbye to the chaos and get a pots and pans organizer. It allows you to neatly store your cookware, making it both efficient and accessible. No more fumbling through the cabinet or drawers to grab the one you need. There are so many options out there, and this one is renter friendly and so easy to put together. You can use it both vertically or horizontally, whichever helps you maximize your kitchen space. And you can adjust the space between the slots, letting you customize it to fit your different size pots and pans, which is what I had to do in the end. Don't forget a lid organizer to keep those neat and tidy as well, and you'll thank yourself the next time you need to cook.
Baby, now I got the flow.
I'm about to pull up. His wishful colors. And I've been waiting so long. Now I gotta resurface. Here we about to toss up. How the bed and we burn it. Cause I've been feeling cool time. I've been fucking cool time. We turn up.
Your teachers aren't gonna recognize you once you start doing this. So if you wanna get your grades up, you're gonna need to start getting organized. I want you to load up Google Drive and create folders for all your classes this fall. No more scrolling through a mess of random files. You're also gonna use a calendar app and create 3 separate calendars. One for your personal life, one for academics, and one for extracurriculars. To top it off, you're gonna color code everything so your calendar matches your Drive folders, which match your actual folders.
All right, if you're anything like me and you absolutely hate having a dirty home, especially dirty floors, I am about to give you the best advice ever. It's really not that hard to have and maintain a clean home that meets your standards. There's just a few rules that you're going to have to learn to enforce in your life, and they're really not that hard, I promise. Basically, don't ever have a husband, don't have children, and don't have pets. And I know what you're thinking. Riley, I already have those things. That's fine. It is totally fine. It is never too late to get rid of them. No matter how much you love them, how cute and cuddly they are, it's
things we do as parents that you might not agree with. First of all, we bought our daughter a little vanity, and if she wants to do her makeup, she can. Whenever I go to Ulta or Sephora, I always let her pick something out. She loves watching me do makeup, and she loves doing hers. We bought her a queen-size bed. We love taking her to the spa to get her nails done and her hair done. We don't do screen time. Instead, we love playing outside, going on the ATV, bike rides, dirt bike rides, and we buy her designer goods. She takes care of them, and they're a great investment. What do you think? Do you agree with these things? Why or not?
The book by Gretchen Rubin, and let me tell you, that is exactly how I feel when I declutter. I've been decluttering one area of my home a day since the new year started, and I feel amazing. Every time I declutter a new space, it feels like a weight has been lifted off my shoulders, and let me tell you, it is so much easier to find things now. Also, I've been finding things I didn't even know I had. I literally found 2 checks today that I hadn't deposited. Like, how irresponsible am I for not depositing my checks? I don't know. But I was very happy about it. I hope this gives you a little bit of motivation to declutter an area of your home.
Hacks to create a functional bedroom. Number one, buy all the same socks so you don't have to pair them up, and skip the expensive dividers and just use dollar bins. Number three, no fold is gold. You do not have to fold your comfy and athletic wear. Number four, if you have limited shelving, use storage bins at the bottom of your closet to hold categories like shoes and purses. And number five, the most important, give yourself a bedroom junk drawer. Doesn't have to be pretty, it just needs to hold all that random stuff that ends up on your surfaces.
Stock the guest bathroom. Skincare first, I'm putting it on this thing. This is gonna be the shower bar. Sol de Janeiro. And Frenchie. I think that's how you say it. I don't know. Next shelf's gonna have Olaplex. And Way. Last shelf is kind of random. Yeah, moving on. Found these drawers for under the sink. Extra hair stuff. Stuff to shave with. Makeup, you never know. Lastly, dental stuff and more skincare. This is kind of how it's gonna be laid out. Perfume in case they forgot. I'm also putting these bags here in case they want to take any minis. Lipstick, deodorant, tree hut scrub, mini bath salts, how cute, loofahs, and bath bombs. Let's ignore the no decorations or shower curtains. This looks so good. I'm so proud of myself. This looks amazing. Believe it or not, the key to a clean house is not a Sunday reset. As much as I do love a Sunday reset, the key to a clean house is having a solid daily cleaning routine. And you've got to make it easy for yourself. For example, every morning when I wake up, I make my bed. Then I get dressed and put a load of washing on, because having a load of washing on is a really easy way to feel productive. I put last night's dishes away before I make my breakfast, and every night after dinner, I tidy off the dining table because it gets full of clutter. It's our dumping ground, and it genuinely makes the whole house feel tidy when the kitchen and dining areas are clean. Now, usually I will look at the laundry and walk straight past it, but I'm trying to be better at this, so I'm habit stacking. While I watch TV, I'll fold my washing. It's really no skin off my nose. Unfortunately, we have one of those couches that needs daily maintenance, so after we finish watching TV, I'll give it a little fluff. And I'll put anything and everything back in its home, like this throw that I left in the blanket basket that actually belongs on our guest bed. It really is that simple.
This is my beauty station. It's in my closet. I did a video a while back of when I set this up, but my makeup has gotten very unorganized since then, so we're gonna reorganize. Okay, in this drawer, we're gonna do all my basic everyday makeup. I'm gonna use these containers to organize it all. Starting off here, we're gonna do skin tint. Okay, in this one, we'll do face primers and setting sprays, concealers and bronzers. Okay, in these last two, I'm gonna do my most used powders and also my eyelash and eyebrow products. Okay, my everyday makeup drawer is done. Let me know if you want a part two of organizing all my other products.
Monthly car clean plus restock.
This pretty little rug definitely won't survive, and if it does, it'll be pretty much unrecognizable. Here in Canada, winter gets really messy. We'll be tracking in snow, slushy dirty snow, salt from the roads to melt the snow, and tiny gravel rocks. Like I said, it gets messy. I should have done this last week when we had our first big snowfall, but I was way too sick. I needed to declutter some old shoes and sandals that won't fit by the time winter is done, and make better room for every pair of winter boots, because there's nothing worse than stepping into a wet spot on the floor from boots that were thrown every which way. We do have a mudroom off the garage, but we don't come through there ever, and it's pretty much used as a storage space, so this is our main entrance. I also made sure to wash some of the extra gloves, hats, and neck warmers that my kids will eventually need if they lose the other ones. Any other parents have stashes of these in a basket too? It's looking so much better, but man, do I hate the winter months.
Yo, I think I messed up. I thought I wanted to clean out my closet, so I took everything out, but now I don't want to put it back. I did get these matching hangers though, so I'm hoping if I hang everything up, it'll look like really satisfying. So let's just start with that and hang everything up. Baby. literally sweating from doing this,
but this is what it looks like so far. Love how cute it looks, and I feel like the white hangers really just tied everything together, and the drawers are so satisfying. Like, I love this. This is a pajama drawer,
but everything looks so cute. I'm literally
restock video in a while, so let's organize. All these products are for my guests to use while they stay here. They can take them home, leave them, whatever. First step, we'll do the oral drawer. Okay, oral drawer is done. Next step is hair stuff. Next step, shaving supplies. Soap products. Next up, facial care. All the boxes are gonna go below the sink. We still have all the skincare and body care. Let me know if you want a part two.
Sometimes I feel like the biggest fraud, like the fact that I make TikToks about organizing my fridge and my fridge actually looks like this right now. I'm a fraud, I'm a liar, but more importantly, I'm in need of a fridge reset. So I'm doing the usual, I'm taking everything out and sorting through what's expired and what's not, and then I'm gonna do it deep. And to be real, this process is about so much more than just organizing my fridge. I'm not exactly the healthiest right now. I've been off and on traveling for like 2 months and I just feel like a mess, and I haven't been cooking at all or excited about food in general. I mean, I think all of us have kind of a complicated relationship with food, right? I don't know, but I am doing this so that I can get excited about my fridge again. This self-push can situation, I had to kind of MacGyver it, so don't order the ones I ordered, they were a pain in the ass to set up. I mean, how fun. It's like your fridge is a vending machine. I'm not a fan of the like all plastic organization, so I love this little canvas shelf and then these adorable berry containers. I got these water containers to make me excited to drink water. I'm gonna do different fruit waters, I'll show you guys. I also am trying to stop buying coffee out, so I got these little milk carton container things to store my coffee and milk. This is a butter keeper. I got it for the aesthetic. We'll see if I use it. So here's my setup for organization. I'm really excited to stock it, and I'll show you that video next.
Are you ready to admit the organizers were a fail?
They're not a fail. Oh. I just haven't figured out how to lay them out yet.
One egg.
It wouldn't fit in my egg organizer.
What a funny use of space.
Well, that is not a good example, but look at my apples. How convenient is it to just come in here and grab an apple at your leisure? But the problem is I think I just bought too many apples. Like, there's just so many apples. But actually, one of the real reasons I bought those holders is that they easily fit cans like that, you see?
Then why are our cans in here?
Well, because there wasn't a tray available. There's also a few other containers I need to buy. Like, there's a sauce container I can buy. So this-
There's more?
Yeah, so this isn't so chaotic.
You're kidding me.
There's also aesthetic containers we can put our milk in.
TikTok, please tell her she needs to stop.
officially entered my psycho cleaning girl era in 2023. Every single Saturday, I clean the absolute fuck out of my house, and it's just such a vibe. I feel like I just really have my shit together. Also, we went to a vintage store today, found all these sick matchboxes, and you guys know I just got this matchbox tattoo yesterday. Could that not be more perfect? Anyways, it's been such a nice little disciplined thing that I do every single Saturday. I've been doing it for about 2 months now, and I just cannot imagine my life any other way. Like, for the rest of my life, all of my Saturdays are gonna be a cleaning day. I just know it. So I plan on having a massive, gorgeous, luxurious home one day. So you know what? I'm just like in training for that. I don't care if I have a condo that's from the 80s that has no updates whatsoever. I will still be cleaning it like it is a goddamn mansion. And then I was gonna open some PR and then I decided not to. I just wanna do that with you guys another time, I think. And dry January is going well. Thank you for asking. I'm drinking ginger beer out of a wine glass and I did just use a label maker to mark my tofu. Guys, I'm obsessed. It's in my Amazon storefront. Don't you worry. It's so cute. But here's my little fried rice bowl with my tofu and my pickled cabbage. It's so good. Okay, love you. Bye.
How often do you clean your vacuum? Because I can't even remember the last time I cleaned mine, and it shows. Let's hacksaw away at this wig that I apparently sucked up without realizing it. In case you're wondering, this is the Dyson Ball Animal 2. Do I have animals? No. I have 3 sons, but I gotta take full credit for being the furball that nearly jammed the vacuum here.
Holy sh! How am I not bald?
With the fresh haircut, let's take this apart now and clean it all. I pondered taking the whole thing apart and really getting in there, but I quickly backtracked when I realized I would not be able to put it back together. So I am thoroughly cleaning what I know I am capable of putting back together, because good enough is better than a broken vacuum. Now, do I recommend this vacuum? It is quite pricey. You can certainly find a great vacuum for a lot less, but I will say this specific one has cleaned up after a Yeti for years with zero qualms. But that was only after I returned the 2 previous identical Dysons I got at Costco because they were lemons that broke after a week or two. So if you ever want to get a bougie vacuum, get it at Costco, because if anything goes awry, they have the best return policy. Like and follow for more.
Best cleaning hack of 2023, the couch cleaning hack. Watch how I do it.
First off, remove all your couch cushions and give it a very good vacuum, okay? I like to get into all the crevices. I do the top, I do the armrests, and I do the whole thing. Boil up some water and pop a dishwashing tablet into a glass bowl. Pour the boiling water over it. Be careful, this might be hot. Pop in your microfiber cloth and let it cool down. Once it's cooled down, wring it out and wrap it around a pot lid. Now let's get to it. You're going to wipe down your couch starting from the top, work your way down to the bottom, the armrests, and you're going to be surprised and shocked at how gross this is. On to lounge number 2. Same thing, lay out your cloth, wrap it around the pot lid and go for gold. Now I've got to tell you something. I was shocked at what I saw come out of my couch. I like to give it a really good clean once a year, but geez. This was crazy. Look at the water. Lastly, repeat the process on your couch cushions, leave everything to dry, and voila, couch is clean.
अस्सलाम वालेकुम जी, ये पुराने घर से मेरा कुछ सामान आया था तो ये तकरीबन 1.5 से 2 हफ्ते हो गए. बीच में मैं बीमार हो गई थी और फातिमा की भी तबीयत नहीं थी ठीक, तो मैंने कहा आज मेरे पास टाइम है तो मैं ये सारा सामान ना समेट लूँ. इनमें से जो काफ़ी चीज़ें थी ना वो धोने वाली थी, तो साथ ही साथ मैं ऑटोमेटिक मशीन में वॉश कर रही थी. अच्छा, ये सारा काम करते हुए, सफाई करते हुए मुझे पूरा दिन तकरीबन गुजर गया था. तकरीबन 5 से 6 घंटे मेरे AC में लग गए थे, और कुछ जो बच्चों के कपड़े थे मैंने वॉश भी करने वाले थे, और कुछ कपड़े मैंने डिक्लटर भी करने थे, तो वो साथ ही साथ वो भी वाश कर रही थी. अच्छा जी, सारा जो सामान था मैं समेट रही थी, क्योंकि इसका जो है ना मेकअप आप से ना जल्दी शेयर करूँगी इस रूम का, क्योंकि इस रूम का जी फर्नीचर भी आने वाला है, तो मैंने कहा चलें आपके साथ भी शेयर करूँगी, आपको कुछ आइडियाज़ वगैरह नए मिल जाएंगे। तो झाड़ू वगैरह लगा के मैंने सारा कूड़ा वगैरह इकट्ठा करके इसके बाद जी अच्छी तरह फिनाइल से मप वगैरह लगाया, विंडो वगैरह साफ़ की, और जब ये रूम साफ़ हो गया और दिल इतना खुश हुआ।
Cleaning my room at 3 a.m. I always say I'm never gonna let it get this bad again, and then it gets bad again. One thing that has really helped me is having organizers and kind of having a system where I sweep once a week and dust once a week. But these drawers have been driving me insane. I know nobody's gonna be looking in here. This looks organized, but just for now, when I can't find that one pair of leggings, it's gonna get messy all over again. And I hate it. I went looking for some drawer dividers, and of course, everything is so expensive. Why were these almost $20? For plastic? I'm very skeptical of Temu. I don't know. I kinda wanna try it. I read an article from US Today saying they're affordable because they just cut out the middleman, but they sell the same products, which I did find. I hate when I have to buy these dusters because they cost so much, and look, they were here for like $2. They have HackerOne as their cybersecurity, so I feel safe. And you can't beat the price, so I decided to just read some reviews. This one sold me. I'm very happy with this item. I actually find them better than the actual Swiffer brand. This one says they clean for a living and they're very pleased. Tell me they don't look identical. My total came out to $676. I'm very happy as someone who's trying to save money. But let me go back to cleaning, and I'm really excited when my stuff finally gets here.
Wie häufig macht ihr eigentlich eure Küche sauber? Ich muss zugeben, obwohl ich nicht jeden Tag koche, putze ich trotzdem täglich die Küche. Irgendwie werde ich aber das Gefühl nicht los, dass man mit der Küchenarbeit einfach nie fertig wird. Deswegen habe ich euch bei meinem heutigen Küchenputz mal wieder mitgenommen. Ich bin Lea von Clean Talk, um kein Video mehr zu verpassen, macht das bloß weg. Meistens beginne ich damit, das Geschirr und den Müll vom Vortag wegzuräumen, weil ich meistens nach dem Kochen abends keine Kraft mehr zu putzen habe. Danach spüle ich dann noch alles, was mit der Hand gespült werden muss. Sobald das passiert ist, lasse ich noch das Sieb der Spüle und Kalkablagerung in Essig einweichen. Danach kann ich mich auch schon aufs Putzen vorbereiten und
und endlich damit loslegen, den Herd mal wieder richtig schön sauber zu machen. Hierfür habe ich diesmal einen Scrub-Mami-Schwamm verwendet. Die habe ich nämlich gestern bei Action entdeckt und ich musste mir unbedingt welche davon mitnehmen. Ich muss wirklich sagen, ich bin beeindruckt davon, wie schnell und gründlich ich mit diesem Schwamm alles sauber bekommen habe. Mich würde mal interessieren, ob ihr die Scrub-Mami-Schwämme schon mal ausprobiert habt. Wenn ja, was ihr davon haltet. Schreibt es gerne mal in die Kommentare. Unseren Wasserkocher reinige ich meist, indem ich Wasser und Zitronensäure hineingebe und das Ganze einmal aufkochen lasse. Danach bekommt dann noch das ganze Spülbecken ein Deep Clean. Auch hier war ich wieder begeistert davon, wie gut das Ganze mit diesem Schwamm funktioniert hat. Danke fürs Zuschauen und bis bald!
Saturday, let's organize the laundry room. I've lived here for 7 months and just now doing this, we're gonna put all the stuff in their containers and then organize the backstock.
We're gonna start with scent boosters. OxyClean. Now restocking the softener. Washing stuff is done. The dryer, we just have the dryer sheets. Okay, now that the cabinet stuff is done, it's time to organize all the backstock. Okay, backstock is done. Everything's in its place. I now have a clear counter. Let me know what you think.
This is a moment of silence honoring key force. Today we share a common space and join in a common cause on behalf of peace. From our first breath to our last, each of us tells a unique story with our lives. Today we honor Pete in this opportunity to save the life of another person. For all the children, grandchildren, friends, family, and staff who are touched by what we do here today, may we remember that fresh hopes and dreams begin with the gift of this one person. Let us now take a moment in silence to remember Heath Morris and all joined by his story from this moment and in the days to come.
Not only is this a vanity, a nightstand, and a desk, but it has a hidden pull-out chair. This thing is super compact, but let me tell you, it holds so much. So I'm gonna put my hair products and a few other random things up here. I love that it does have a built-in LED light. The design on this thing is so smart, especially if you have limited space. I put so much in here, but it could hold a lot more. So when you flip this up, you have a place to do your hair and makeup. You can put your jewelry right here. So this drawer I'm going to use to organize my makeup. I love these organizers because they don't slide around in the drawer. That drives me insane. So yes, you do have to put this thing together, but no, it is not hard. It does take a little bit, but it's made really nice and it wasn't damaged from shipping. This holds so much makeup, but I'm going to go ahead and put more where the jewelry goes. And then I'm going to put some rings in there too. Okay, so I actually forgot to put this in here. It's so annoying that my nose runs every single time I do my makeup. I was only going to put one perfume in here. I mean, it's kind of one. Whoever designed this literally squeezed on every feature you possibly could. This is the button for the lights. You can charge your phone or plug in your hair tools. The chair that pulls out actually does have a drawer and it has so much storage. I said they squeezed in every feature. There's even hooks on both sides. I absolutely love this thing. I will have it on my bio underneath my bedroom favorites.
We just moved into a small Toronto apartment, and it's finally time to organize my tiny wardrobe. This is it for my closet, so I'm a minimalist everywhere except for my clothes, and our bedroom was just too small to hold our dresser, so I needed to get creative to optimize this small space. So I started out by emptying out my wardrobe, and then I got assembling this wire drawer unit from IKEA. Let's be real, actually my boyfriend did it for me, but it turned out really well, it fit perfectly, and I also ordered these scub drawer organizers from IKEA because I wanted to make sure my clothes wouldn't fall through the holes or get wire marks on them, and everything fit so perfectly, so satisfying. Then I got to KonMari folding all of my stuff, that means vertical folding, folding into thirds, and I really couldn't believe how well everything fit in here. I'll show you at the end. Then I moved on to my shoes. I ordered these clear shoe box organizers from Amazon, and I'm not gonna lie, it was a bit of a struggle to assemble them, but once I did, I love how it turned out. I'm a size 7 shoe, and I could fit multiple pairs of shoes in one box, and even some boots in here. The doors on the front of these make it just really easy and convenient to access everything, and I love that I can finally see all my shoes, because I used to just store them in the boxes before. 10 out of 10 would recommend. And this is the final result. I'm in love with how everything turned out here. I really felt like an organizational queen. Now I can't wait to get dressed every day, so make sure you follow along for more small space living tips.
Let me teach you the easiest way to really deep clean your sink drains without having to take anything apart. Now, at the bottom of every kitchen or bathroom sink drain, there is a curved pipe, which is normally called a P-trap. This stops sewer gases from re-entering your home and also traps larger debris from flowing further into the plumbing system, causing clogs. You can imagine this gets stinky over time. Also, speaking of clogs, if your sink is really clogged and things like Drano aren't working, you can get one of these little plungers for your actual sink drains. But to really deep clean the drain and flush out that still water and debris trapped in the bottom, I start by loosening and softening softening all of the residue by pouring boiling water down. I immediately follow this up with my steamer for a few minutes to further soften and loosen any of the debris stuck on the sides. And now I know there's a lot of controversy about my next step because so many people think using baking soda and vinegar together is pointless. And while yes, mixed together, they basically do create a salty water, what they fail to realize is that the cleaning chemical properties are not what we're looking for here. It's the chemical action and the odor neutralizing. When combined, they create a foaming action due to the release of carbon dioxide. This helps to physically agitate and dislodge debris. Now, the key here is to immediately place half a cup of baking soda down the drain and ensure it reaches the bottom where the catch is located. Follow it with a cup of vinegar and immediately cover it with a wet cloth, ensuring the force goes downward. Wait until the reaction stops and then pour another cup of vinegar down and cover it again with the wet cloth. This forces the reaction down instead of up through the sink. It will push through the still water and debris as well as any buildup along the inside of the drain. Then run another round of boiling water to wash everything through. Stay tuned because tomorrow we are deep cleaning the dishwasher.
Okay guys, so this is our trash can and it just needs a really good deep spring cleaning. I'm gonna take out the trash. Okay, so since I live in an apartment, I don't have like anywhere to hose down the trash can and I really don't want to use my showers. So the next best option is to use this toilet wand. I'm just gonna work my way from the top of the trash can in, down, inside, and then all around. I'm gonna use this tool first to kind of like pick out any gunk that's stuck in there. Lift this lid and get all the crevices in here. I'm gonna take a wet paper towel and just wipe everything down. Inside is done. We're gonna go ahead and disinfect the outside. Gonna restock the trash bags.
a little extra boost, I always put this Pura air freshener right by the trash.
That's pretty much it. It looks super nice and clean, and it smells really, really good for a trash can.
If you want to be that girl, then you need to know how to properly clean and store your produce, and I'm here to show you how. First, we will spend an hour scrubbing our sinks until they are shining bright and disinfected with a sponge mommy and some pink stuff. And don't forget to use your husband's toothbrush to get those dirtiest areas clean. And once your sink is all prepped, you will add some clean, fresh water. And of course, to make our water more alkaline, we will add some baking soda and stir. Next, you will test your water with your pH drops to make sure that the water has become perfectly alkaline. Next, you will add your organic bug-infested berries to the water bath. And next, for aesthetic purposes only, I will add things with peels, such as oranges, lemons, and limes. They obviously don't need to be washed beforehand, but they do make my fruit cocktail bath look so much prettier. Now you will give your fruit a quick rinse to remove all that nasty baking soda. I'm not really sure why that girl's add the baking soda, because now the berries will be ruined and soggy. Don't forget to show all the dirt and bugs that were removed from the baking soda. Although I didn't have any, I had to get these from my doorframe. Round two, we will scrub and wash our vegetables, although do not do this with sweet potatoes because apparently it ruins them when you get them wet. Then we will add our strawberries to our spinning carousel, which removes all excess liquid. Now we will add our soggy, wet fruits and vegetables to our labeled produce bins that we will add to our highly organized refrigerator. Although right now, mine is a disaster, so I'm only gonna let you see the top right corner.